Hey guys, so here we're going to factor completely number 21, which is 3x squared plus 5x minus 2. I'm going to show you guys how to approach this problem three ways. Feel free to jump to any method and watch that portion of the video. In the grouping method, I'm going to take this trinomial and make it into four terms. So I'm going to write 3x squared plus 5x minus 2. Now, I'm going to refer this back to the ax squared plus bx plus c form, where my a is 3, my b is 5, and my c is negative 2. So the grouping method is also called the ac method because you multiply the a and the c, giving you in this example, negative 6. So we're going to find two numbers that multiply to make negative 6 that also add to equal the b term, which is 5. So the factors of negative 6 are 1 and negative 6, negative 1 and 6, 3 and negative 2, and negative 3 and 2. I'm going to pick negative 1 and 6 because those are the two factors of negative 6 that also add to make 5. Right? Okay, so I'm going to substitute those factors in instead of this b that I have now. So I'm going to rewrite this as 3x squared plus 6x minus 1x minus 2. And now I'm going to factor by grouping. So I'm going to take my first two terms and find the GCF, take that out. In this case, it's 3x, leaving me with x plus 2. And then I'm going to take the GCF from the next two terms, which is negative 1, leaving me with x plus 2. I could have taken out a positive 1, but that would have left me with negative x minus 2. And I want these two terms to be the same, because in that case, I can just take out my x plus 2 as being my GCF for this whole term, leaving me with 3x minus 1. And that is my answer. Let's try the trial and error method. I'm going to rewrite my problem, 3x squared plus 5x minus 2. And I'm going to take out the factors of 3, which are 1 and 3, and the factors of negative 2, which are 1 and negative 2, and negative 1 and 2. So if a trinomial can be factored, it will always factor into two binomials. So I'm going to write my two bubbles there. And I'm going to start off with 1x here and 3x here. And then I'm going to start off by plugging in 1 and negative 2. So positive 1 and negative 2. And now I'm going to see if that works or if it's an error. So in order to prove that this is the correct one or to see if it's the correct one, you're going to multiply these two together, in this case giving us 3x. And multiply these two together, in this case giving us negative 2x. Now when we add those two terms together, we get x. And we want this term to make the b here. So in this case, we have 1x, and we need it to be 5x. So that tells us that this is not our factor. These are not our factors. So let's try negative 1 and positive 2. So I'm going to write negative 1 here, positive 2 here. Now, let's go ahead and try that again. So negative 1 times 3x is negative 3x, and 1 times 2x is 2x. So when we add those together, we get negative 1x, which is not 5. So these are not our factors. So instead of writing 1 and negative 2, I'm going to write negative 2 and 1. So I'm going to write negative 2 in this box, and then positive 1 in this box. So let's try that. So negative 2 and 3x make negative 6x, and then 1x times 1 makes x. We put these together, that makes negative 5x, which is not what we have here because we want positive 5x. So this is not our, these are not our factors. Okay, we have one more combination we can try. Instead of writing negative 1 and positive 2, we'll write positive 2 first and then negative 1. Let's try that. So positive 2 times 3x gives us 6x, and positive 1x times negative 1 gives us negative x. When we put those two together, that gives us 5x, which is what we have here. So there we go. That's our answer. So I'm going to rewrite that as x plus 2 times 3x minus 1. I just didn't write the 1 here like it is here because you don't need to. It's already a given that there's a 1 there. So that is our answer. So let's try the Berry method. In the Berry method, I'm going to rewrite my problem. 3x squared plus 5x minus 2. So now I'm going to write my parentheses because if we have a trinomial and it's factorable into two binomials. First thing I'm going to do is separate this 3x squared into 3x and 3x. Now I know what you're thinking, that's wrong. And it is wrong, you're right. But the Berry method, you got to know, you got to be aware that it is a shortcut. And it's a shortcut of a bunch of different little rules that don't really make sense, but it'll get you to the right answer. So I'm going to separate this into 3x and 3x, and then I'm going to look at this value and this value. I'm not paying attention to any negatives or positives just yet. So 3 times 2 makes 6, and the factors of 6 are 1 and 6 and 3 and 2. Now, because this is a negative here, I'm looking for the difference of the factors that make 5. So the difference of 1 and 6 are 5, and the difference of 3 and 2 are 1. Okay? So I'm going to pick these factors. And I'm going to write the biggest one in the first bubble and the other one in the second bubble. Okay? Now, because this is a positive here, I'm going to bring that down to my first bubble. And now I'm going to ask myself, what does this sign multiplied to make this sign? So a positive times what makes a negative, in other words? Well, a positive times a negative make a negative. So I'm putting a negative in that second bubble. Now, as my final step, I'm going to simplify and get rid of the GCF. I'm literally just going to make it vanish. So in the first term here, 3x plus 6, I have a GCF of 3. And when I take that out, I'm left with x plus 2. And then here, I don't have a GCF, so I'm just going to bring that down, 3x minus 1. Then I'm just going to erase that like it never happened, and I'm left with x plus 2 times 3x minus 1. And that is our answer.